This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have a very exciting episode for you. I'm here at a green market here in South Florida, and I like to come to farmers markets to check out and buy good produce, but I also like to learn about any plants and other things that are growing on here. And today you guys are very lucky because you guys are going to learn about a rare and even like native plant to Florida you can grow here that's going to do amazingly well. So it's over at the Slow Food booth, so let's go over there and check it out. So there are many thousands of varieties of different plants that grow, and unfortunately, you know, in America, we only eat some of the ones that are commonly domesticated. And here's one right here that's really unknown. It's the native Florida Seminole pumpkin, a delicious taste of Florida's rich history. And this one is not a northern pumpkin. This one was grown literally by the Indians, like for hundreds of years. And here they are right here. And this is a really interesting story on how these were basically rediscovered. So we're here with Trish today, and Trish is gonna tell us more about this rare Seminole pumpkin. So Trish, tell us more about this pumpkin, how you got into these seeds and where they came from.
Well, the director of the market, T.A. Weiner, gave me a little sprout about 3 years ago, which I planted, and I got two pumpkins from it. We didn't know what they were. I saved the seeds, and the following year I planted another dozen plants and have gotten 300 pumpkins from the original 12 plants. I pick them when they're green, then they turn yellow, and then they turn orange. They last for up to a year, and it was a main source of nutrition for the Seminole Indians. They would grow them at the base of trees and train them to climb up into the trees, and they would call them hanging pumpkins. That was the name that they called them.
And is this the full size right here?
That is the biggest one I've grown. It was a little over 3 pounds. This is one of the littler ones. I pick them when they're green to encourage production, and then when you leave them on the shelf, they start to color up, to turn yellow. They're quite sweet when they're green. They're very, very sweet when they turn yellow.
So Trisha, tell me more about the history of this pumpkin and why it's unique and how it almost actually, we almost lost this genetic diversity.
Well, the pumpkins we know go back at least to the 1500s, where they were documented by a Spaniard held captive by the Seminole Indians. It's a main source of nutrition for the Indians. They would eat the blossoms, they would eat the seeds, and they would eat the pumpkin itself, which stores for up to a year. Now, when the soldiers decided to get rid of the Seminole Indians, they destroyed the pumpkins in an effort to starve out the Indians. So now they're one of the top 10 rarest Native American vegetables.
So one of the things that I'm really excited about this pumpkin is many northern pumpkins and squashes are actually just grown during, like, you know, a short season. These guys, I was told that this one will grow year-round here in tropical Florida because it doesn't get too cold and this can tolerate the heat. So tell us more about that, Trish, and how these, you know, grow here.
Well, my original 12 plants that I started 13 months ago are still producing. I've gotten over 300 pumpkins from them. They tend to slow down production in the summertime during the hottest months, June, July, and August, but then they came back and started producing again.
Wow, that's amazing. I love perennial crops, literally crops you could plant just once, and they keep growing and growing and growing, so I'm glad I found this one, and that now more people will learn about these ancient crops like the Seminole pumpkin that are available. So Trisha, I know this is coming, some of my viewers are going to say, hey, where do I get these from? Because I've never even heard of these. How can people contact you to order these seeds?
My email is my last name, Herrera, H-E-R-R-E-R-A, Trish, T-R-I-S-H, at AOL.com. Herrera Trish at AOL.com.
So Trish also sells here at the Palm Beach Gardens Green Market, and as you can see, she's selling little starts of these guys. And these just grow like a regular pumpkin vine, right? Like really, and they spread out, and yep. They could, like, these guys could literally take over. And then she also has the little pumpkins for sale, and she's selling the seeds. So I'm gonna be sure to pick up some of these seeds and see if I could grow these native Florida pumpkins in California. So here's the pumpkin that hopefully I'll be growing pretty soon in California. If I lived in Florida, I'd be definitely growing these, because once again, a perennial crops, they're really worth it. You know, why fight and try to grow northern crops in tropical Florida when you can grow a lot of crops like this and unknown ones? And you know, you gotta go out there and learn about these crops. They don't just fall in your lap unless you're at a farmer's market like I am today. So it's really nice to know about another rare and unique crop and get this out and let more people know about this. So I'm gonna go buy pack of the seeds here and go back to California and grow them next season and have some fun. Hopefully you've enjoyed this quick episode learning more about the Seminole pumpkins. My name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing.